Good morning, everyone. I'm meteorologist Hayley LaPointe. Thank you for logging on to WPTZ.com. Today is town meeting day. Here's the forecast and what you can expect. Some towns having open votes today. So when the polls open this morning, temperatures will be in the upper 20s. There could be some scattered light snow showers through the morning hours, but probably around lunch or just after, that should stop. Temperatures reach the mid to upper 30s. Then this evening, when you're heading out for some of the town meetings, will be cloudy and should be mainly dry, temperatures falling back into the low 30s and probably by the end of the meetings into the 20s. We're still stuck with this storm system on top of us. I've been talking about this for the past few days now. It just won't release its grip on us, or at least there's no system to push it on out of here. So we continue to get the clouds coming down from the system, and same thing with the snow showers from time to time. You can see that there is a batch just to the north of the Champlain Valley now, and I expect those to move through in the morning hours, and then it will become mainly dry. A little bit of drier air out toward our south and west, and clearing taking place too before this next storm system moves through. This is just about to enter the Ohio River Valley and eventually will move toward the nation's capital, bringing in some significant snow there. Now the big question is, some of our computer models are pushing it up closer to us, actually. It'll hug the coast, move right up by the Delmarva Peninsula, up by Long Island, and then possibly gracing southern New England. And of course, the farther inland the system goes, the more of a chance for us to see significant snowfall. I think as far as snowfall for us, it does look like southern Vermont could see a good dumping out of this system again, but once you get farther to the north and certainly to the west, a lot less in the amounts of snow, and there's the possibility of some mixing with sleet and then also plain old rain first. Let's talk a little bit about what's going to happen today, though. In the meantime, there will be snow showers passing through in the morning. Otherwise, we're mostly cloudy. I think maybe in the afternoon there might be some bright spots. We're not going to completely clear out the skies by any means. Then watch what happens tomorrow on our Wednesday. This storm system getting its act together off the coast of the mid-Atlantic here. And then eventually we'll start to move up toward the north. And you see these bands of snow. These start to move in overnight Wednesday and through the day Thursday. Could lift a little bit farther to the north. So we're watching this storm very carefully. Our computer models kind of wavering a little bit, and they're trying to come into agreement with each other. Some of our forecast models bring heavy snow to southern Vermont, especially in the Green Mountains, but much less the farther to the north and west you go. So I think northern New York, Champlain Valley, this is a non-event, but we'll have a little bit of a messy mix, especially in the St. Lawrence River Valley and the Champlain Valley. And there could be some freezing rain along with the sleet and plain old rain, too. So it looks a little bit messy by the time we get to Thursday and even into Friday morning. The winds also pick up with this system. The winds will be strongest, though, farther south in southern New England. Could even be some coastal flooding problems down by Rhode Island and the Cape Cod area and even into Boston. Now, once we get beyond this system, finally, I think we clear things out and start a whole new pattern. And it looks sunny on Saturday. Temperatures in the 40s expected. And then by the time we get to late weekend, we're in the mid-40s, maybe even closer to the upper 40s by the start of next week. And then our next storm system comes in. But this one looks like a messy mix again with limited snow due to how warm we'll be here with temperatures in the mid to upper 40s. Also, a quick reminder, you want to spring your clocks forward when you go to bed Saturday night or if you wake up early Sunday morning. And also remember to check the batteries in your fire detectors. That's a good thing to remember when you're moving your clocks both in the spring and the fall. Thanks for logging on to WPTZ.com. I hope you have a great Tuesday.